How's everybody doing? Are you having a great time? Is everybody having a good time? Okay, good. People aren't sitting in the sun anymore. Everybody's comfortable out there. Can I hear it from the audience? Are you all comfortable now? All right, good. Okay. In thinking about the perfect person to serve as our 2012 commencement speaker, I did not have to look further than to the incomparable Ron Meyer, President and Chief Operating Officer of Universal Studios. Yes. Ron's long list of professional accomplishments is truly remarkable for the range, depth, and groundbreaking importance they hold for the entertainment and performing arts industry. Ron is an executive and leader of incomparable vision, talent, and success. Appointed President and Chief Operating Officer of Universal Studios in 1995, Ron is now the longest serving major studio chief in Hollywood history. Yeah. It's an extraordinary accomplishment. And without question, Ron's long list of successes at Universal cannot be understated, and he and his team have brought us so many memorable films and wonderful television shows that are far too many to name today. But if that weren't enough for one's resume, Ron was also the co-founder of the powerhouse agency CAA, the preeminent talent agency in the world, with its focus on film, television, theater, live performance, sports, music, advertising, digital media, consultation services for major corporations both here and abroad, along with the longest list of the most famous actors, writers, directors, producers, and executives in the entertainment and performing arts industries throughout the world. Ron has represented and helped to support and guide the careers of many of our industry's most talented people through untold successes over the years. What is most important, however, about our choice of commencement speakers today is not so much about Ron's clearly extraordinary professional and visionary accomplishments, but for his inspiring values, his generosity, and the way he has conducted his life and his long and storied career. Ron is a wonderful person, and I feel so honored and so very lucky to know him. He is a man of great personal integrity and a person of conscience. Ron is filled with so much intelligence, warmth, humility, great taste, generosity, empathy, and honesty. And his leadership and people skills are as legendary as the long list of credits on his resume. He believes in the power of education to transform lives as much as he believes in the power of great stories and movies to make a difference. So for all of this and so much more, I felt that Ron was the perfect person to address all of you today for what I know will be a memorable and inspiring commencement address. Ladies and gentlemen, without further delay, and on behalf of our UCLA School of Theater, Film, and Television, it gives me the greatest pride and pleasure to warmly welcome Ron Meyer, our 2012 commencement speaker, to the podium, and to accept this commemorative crystal as a token of our enduring friendship and our utmost respect for all that you have accomplished, Ron, throughout your career, your distinguished career, and your life. Ron Meyer. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Ron.
Well, thank you, Terry. When Dean Schwartz invited me to speak here today, I wasn't sure how to address you, as I didn't want to make this about me. And as I thought it through, I decided that even though your journey in this industry may be different than mine, we probably will have much in common. I realized that in my years, I've learned some things that might be helpful to you. My mother and father were German Jews who escaped Nazi Germany in 1939. They immigrated to the United States and ultimately Los Angeles. My father was a traveling ladies' dress salesman, and I was raised in a very modest but loving home. My parents had hoped I would go to college, get a degree, get a job, But to their disappointment, at 15 years old, I dropped out of school, out of high school. I spent my days doing odd jobs, boxing, shooting pool, and getting into all kinds of trouble. They were proud and relieved when at 17 and a half years old, I joined the Marine Corps. Thank you. In the Marines, I got the measles, and while I was in quarantine, my mother sent me a care package, which included a book entitled The Flesh Peddlers. It was a fictionalized story about a young man who worked at a major talent agency, drove a fast car, didn't work very hard, and dated beautiful women. It seemed like a great way to make a living. Although I didn't know anyone in the entertainment business, when I got out of active duty, I went door to door and applied to every talent agency willing and told them I was willing to do any job that was available. I was ignored or rejected by every one of them. Not having a formal education seemed to limit my possibilities. I had completely given up all hope of a show business career and went back to making a living selling men's clothing, which I was doing at the time. Out of nowhere, one of the agencies I'd interviewed with called and told me their messenger had quit and asked if I was still interested. I, of course, said yes and started immediately. I was hired by the Paul Koner Agency, which represented directors such as William Wyler, Billy Wilder, Ingmar Bergman, John Huston, among others. I initially got the interview because, and you got to pay attention because this will come into play maybe sometime in your life in a relationship part of it. My mother's best girlfriend's husband's sister, truth, was married to Paul Koner's brother. And that was how I got my interview. This is my first important lesson and obviously made a great difference in my career and my life. You never, never know when and how an opportunity will present itself. Luck and timing are essential. I spent 6 years being the best driver, messenger, and gopher I could possibly be. I listened and learned and gratefully said yes to every crappy and menial job they had me do. I was once asked if there was a pivotal moment in my career, and I thought about it and remembered the following. One of my duties at the agency was to file papers for Paul Koner's assistant, who was my boss. Although I had learned a lot from her, she was demanding and occasionally verbally abusive. One day while filing, after being humiliated and embarrassed by her, I got up and yelled loud enough that the entire office could hear me say to her, "Take this job and shove it, I quit." My pride intact, I marched out the door thinking that everyone would come after me, begging me to return, believing I was an irreplaceable great messenger and that they would not be able to function without me. I kept walking until I realized that no one was coming after me. I now had my first major career decision and ultimately a life-changing choice to make. I could go back to selling clothes or suck it up and return to work. I decided I wasn't ready to give up on show business. I went back and continued filing, and we all acted as if nothing had happened. At that point in my career, the lesson was, don't let your ego get in the way of your future and always try to see the big picture. I'm not ever suggesting that any kind of abuse is acceptable, but pick your spots. I chose to lose the battle and win the war. Remember, no one is irreplaceable. From the Koner Agency, through a number of interviews and good fortune, I became a television agent at the William Morris Agency. After 5 years at William Morris, four of my fellow agents and I left and started Creative Artist Agency, where I stayed as president for 20 years. 17 years ago, as Terry said, I left Creative Artist Agency and went to Universal Studios as president and chief operating officer. I oversee the worldwide operations for film, theme parks, and the physical studio and its 15,000 employees. I tell you this because I was the least likely to succeed. As I look back on my career, I realize there were a number of things that made a difference and helped me along the way. First, whatever you do, do it the best you can with a positive attitude. No job is too small or unimportant. Treat people the way you want to be treated. It may sound cliche and corny, but it is not as easy to do as you think. Nice guys don't have to finish last. Be strong, generous, honest, thoughtful, and kind. This business often gets a bad rap, but you'll find that most people in this industry are good, decent, and intelligent. And as you move ahead in your career, you might have to make some tough decisions. Take people's lives and feelings into consideration, then you can make those decisions with a clear conscience. Don't mistake kindness for weakness. Ultimately, you want the story of your life to be one you're proud of. Your personal integrity is of enormous value, and if lost, it's very, very difficult to restore. Jobs come and go, but your reputation matters. You don't have to be an asshole to succeed.
Yeah.
Never be embarrassed not to know the answers. Don't let fear or pride keep you from getting the right information. You don't have to have all the answers, and you should not be afraid to make mistakes. I've made many. Turning down the film Titanic was not my biggest. You will make mistakes. Don't be afraid to admit and own them. You won't fool anybody. And last but not least, when I was a messenger, I once saw a phrase on a wall which made a huge difference in my career. Assumption is the mother of all fuck-ups. Don't assume if you ask someone to do something for you, it will get done or done right. You have to be responsible for what someone else does or doesn't do for you. Double check everything that you will be responsible for. You need to do the things you say you're going to do. People should know they can depend on you. Please, please remember that phrase. I'm going to say it again. It may be the most important thing I say to you today. Assumption is the mother of all fuck-ups. I promise, if you remember it, one day it will make a difference. It's possible that not all of you who graduate today will make it in the entertainment industry. Many people get frustrated and can't stick it out. It's a tough, competitive business and will take a lot of fortitude to hang in during the toughest of times. Talent is essential, but it's not enough. Keep your eyes and ears open. Take chances. Watch for the right openings, especially early in your careers. Be open to opportunities, as you never know who or what they can lead to. During the 5 years I was at William Morris, there were times I felt that the layers of important agents ahead of me would make it impossible for me to move forward. I used to think that some of them would have to either quit, die, or go to jail for me to succeed. I waited long enough, and eventually many died, quit, or went to jail. I learned anything is possible. Never underestimate the importance of relationships. For many of you, it all starts by finding an agent. And for most of your careers, people will find it easy to say no. Your job is to find a way to turn those no's into yeses. This is going to require perseverance, resourcefulness, determination, personality, talent, and luck. Find a way to get yourself or your material to someone. Ask everyone you meet and everyone you know, your friends, your family friends, your mechanic, your doctor, your hairdresser, your professors, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And I'm not joking. Just don't ask me. Whether you want to act, write, direct, or produce, you're going to need an agent. Doing your craft will be the easiest thing you do, and for most of you, getting an agent will be the hardest. You're going to need someone to champion and believe in you. I don't say that lightly. It's the easiest thing to say, it's the hardest thing to do, but you're going to have to find one, and I mean it. Ask everybody you know, everybody you meet, everybody you're in contact with. You live in a company town, and someone somewhere will know an agent just like they did in my career. They will know it in your career. You no doubt came to the school because somewhere along the way you fell in love with show business and probably the art and craft of storytelling. There's still nothing better than experiencing the magic of a play, watching a television show, or going to the movies. The stories unite us in shared ways, while at the same time, they affect us as individuals. Whether it's film, television, animation, digital media, or theater as artists, you want to make people laugh, cry, or feel a whole range of emotions. It's an extraordinary way to make a living. I feel lucky and proud still each day to be part of this great business. The industry will be different for you than it was when I started 47 years ago. You're facing an uncertain economy, more competition than ever, and challenges to the economic models of virtually every aspect of our business. Don't be discouraged by people talking about the decline and problems in our business. It's a great business with endless opportunities. People have always predicted doom and gloom, and so far, and as far as I can remember, they have always been and continue to be wrong. and it's true. I've always felt it's a miracle when someone says yes to an individual or a project. The good news for you is that miracles happen every single day. It's been a great honor for me to be here with you today, and none of us would be here without the faculty of the School of Theater, Film, and Television and UCLA Chancellor Jean Block. I must also acknowledge my friend Dr. Judith Reichman and the beautiful tribute that was done here today in honor of my great friend and her late husband, Gil Cates. Right now, you're graduating from the best theater, film, and television schools in the country. Be proud of your accomplishments. Continue to believe in yourselves and your futures. Refuse to give up. Everything is possible. Thank you.
Wow, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Ron Meyer. Thank you.